فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. We're in the series that we were doing, which we were talking about a woman getting married without the consent of her guardian. What is the ruling in the Kitab and the Sunnah, in the Sharia? What is the ruling regarding it? We had a muqaddimah, introduction, where we spoke about ما هو الدليل, what is the evidence? And then the second part, we spoke about حكم النكاح بدون ولي. What is the ruling of a marriage without the consent of the guardian? And we tackled that topic in our second part. Today, inshaAllah ta'ala, today, بإذن الله الكريم, we are going to be speaking about من هو الولي, من هو الولي في النكاح. Who is the guardian in nikah? We keep saying that the guardian is his consent is required in order for the legitimacy of a marriage. But the question is, من هو الولي? Who is a guardian? Who is a guardian? Inshallah ta'ala, the way I hope to go through this is بإذن الله الكريم is to quote the a'immah, the scholars, what they have said. And I'm going to, inshallah ta'ala, bring at least one quote from each madhab. So the Ahnaf, I'm going to bring one quote. The Malikiyah, I'm going to bring a quote from them. The Shafi'iyah, a quote. And the Hanabila. Keeping in mind, in the Muqaddimah I mentioned, that the A'imma do not differ. The scholars do not differ that a woman has a guardian. They don't differ on that. They all unanimously agree upon that. That a woman has a guardian. But what they do differ upon, as I said in the Muqaddimah, was what? If the guardian is a condition for the marriage. And we spoke about the true, correct opinion regarding this when we were talking about حكم النكاح بدون ولي, when we gave the evidences and the rulings. So that's why I'm saying that Ahnaf and the Malikiyah and the Shafi'iyah and the Hanabila, each of them one quote, بإذن الله الكريم. But before all of that, let me give you the wali in order. And then inshallah we go to the kalam of the ulama. The wali, the guardian of the girl, is as follows. The first one is her father. Her father, the girl's father, is her guardian, number one. Number two is her granddad from her father's side, her dad's dad. The third is her brother, who has the same mum and same dad as her. Her brother from the same mum and dad. The fourth is her brother from her father only, if there's one. Number five is her nephew from her brother who has the same mom and dad as her. Her nephew who has, from the nephew has to be from the brother who has the same mom and dad as her. Number six is her nephew from her brother who has the same mom, same dad as him. Who has the same dad as him. Sorry, he has the same dad as her. So let me say, number six is what? Her nephew who has her nephew from her brother who has the same dad as her. Number seven, her uncle. But this uncle has to have the same mom and same dad as her father. We're talking about her paternal uncle. So he has to be the paternal uncle, and he has to be the same mom and same dad as her father. Number 8. Her paternal uncle, who only has the same father as her dad. Number 9. Ibn Ammiha, her cousin, from her paternal uncle, who has the same mom and same dad as her father. So her cousin, from her paternal uncle, and that uncle has the same mom and same dad as the father. The 10th, which is the last one, is her cousin, from her paternal uncle, who has the same father as her father. Those are the asabah of the mar'ah. Those are known as the asabatul mar'ah. And they are the wali of the girl. Now we're going to see, inshallah ta'ala, بعض أقوال أهل العلم من كل مذهب إن شاء الله تعالى في تحديد الولي. This, إن شاء الله تعالى, statement, I'm going to now reference it from the scholars, إن شاء الله. You are also going to see something, إن شاء الله, and I want you to keep this in mind, which is the عصبة of the مرأة. The عصبة are these that I mentioned. They all unanimously agree upon, and I'm going to bring the إجماع إن شاء الله تعالى, that the asaba are the awliya of the mar'ah. Those which I mentioned were the asaba, are the awliya, the guardians of the girl. But some of the a'imma, they also added onto the asaba those who are known as ulul arham. The ulul arham are her maternal uncle, her brother from the same mother as her, her brother from the same mother as her, and etc. They also added them onto the awliya, they also added them onto the list of the guardians for the girl. So now, inshallah ta'ala, I'm going to start with the first quote from the A'immatu al-Ahnaf. The Hanafi madhab. Al-Imam Muhammad ibn Abdullah ibn Muhammad ibn Tumratashi. He mentions in his book Tanwirul Absar. He mentions in it, he says, Al-Waliyu fi nikah al-Asaba. He says, the Wali, the guardian, in the marriage is the asaba. Is the asaba. Binafsihi, he became the asaba through himself. Bila tawsita untha ala tartib al-irthi wal-hajbi. Without the link through a female. In other words, it can't come from the ulul arham. It can't come from the mother side. He has to have the asaba through her lineage. And these are the ones who are her lineage, the ones I mentioned, the 10. So he doesn't allow the ulul arham. Bila tawsita untha. It can't be through the lineage and the line of a female. Can't be through the mom. And then he goes, ala tartib al-irthi wal-hajbi. In the order of the inheritance and the hajb. And those who can prevent one another from the irth, the inheritance. And those are the 10, as I mentioned. They are the tartibul irth. The inheritance are like that. Those are the list of the inheritance. I mentioned it. The Malikiyya. قال الحافظ ابن حجر العسقلاني رحمه الله في فتح الباري. Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani, he says in Fathul Bari, which is the Sharh of Sahih al-Bukhari, He says, قال ابن بطال. Ibn Battal is أئمة المالكية. He's from the Maliki scholars, who has an explanation on Sahih al-Bukhari. Ibn Hajar says, قال ابن بطال. Ibn Battal said, اختلفوا في الولي. They differed with one another regarding the wali. What does he mean here? You have to understand Ibn Battal's statement. He means whether the Ulul Arham are part of the guardians, are they part of the wali, or are they not, is what the khilaf is. He's going to bring it later, inshallah ta'ala, in his quote. فقال الجمهور ومنهم مالك والثوري والليث بن سعد والشافعي وغيرهم. They differed regarding the wali. فقال الجمهور, the overwhelming majority of the scholars have said, such as Malik, Thawri, Layth, Shafi'i, and other than them, they said al-awliya fi nikah humul asaba. Al-Imam Malik, al-Thawri, al-Layth, al-Shafi'i, they said that the awliya, the guardians, are who? Fi nikah, in marriage, for the girl, are humul asaba. They are the asaba. Walaysa lil khali, the maternal uncle, wala walidul ummi, and her brother from her mother's side, about the child, sorry, the parent of the mother, sorry, wala walidul ummi, the mother's father. So walaysa lil khali, it is not for the maternal uncle, wala walidul ummi, and the mother's father. وَلَا الْإِخْوَةُ مِنَ الْأُمِّ, and also the brothers from her mother. وَنَحْوِ هَؤُلَاءِ وِلَايَةٌ, they do not have wilaya. So Ibn Battal is saying what? الْأَوْلِيَاء فِي النِّكَاحِ, in the nikah, for the woman, the awliya are who? هُمُ الْعَصَبَةُ. وَلَيْسَ لِلْخَالِ, the maternal uncle. وَلَا وَالِدُ الْأُمِّ, and the father of the mother, وَلِلْإِخْوَةُ مِنَ الْأُمِّ, and the brothers who have the same mother as her, and like them, they do not have wilayah, they do not have guardianship, they don't have it. وَعَنِ الْحَنَفِيَّةِ, but the Hanafi madhab, the qawl which is mu'tamad, is what? هُمْ مِنَ الْأَوْلِيَاء, that they are from the awliya. Now we have the Shafi'iyah. We have the Shafi'iyah, which is the third. قال الإمام الشافعي رحمه الله. الإمام الشافعي said في الأم, in his كتاب الأم, he said ولا ولاية لأحد مع أب. الإمام الشافعي said there is no ولاية, there is no guardianship لأحد, for anybody, مع أب, when the father is there. Whilst the father is alive, there is no other guardian. Pay attention to this. فَإِذَا مَاتَ, if the father dies, فَالْجَدُّ أَبُو الْأَبِي, the granddad, the dad's dad. Her dad, his dad, her granddad. فَإِذَا مَاتَ, if the granddad dies, فَالْجَدُّ أَبُو الْجَدُّ, the father of the granddad. Why? لِأَنَّ كُلَّهُمْ أَبٌ, because all of them are fathers. If the great-great-granddad and the great-great, if they're all alive, they are always there. They take precedence over everybody. As soon as the father moves out, the granddad, when I said أَبُ الْأَبْ, that goes on. If anyone from the dad's dad's alive, they take precedence over the brothers and the uncles. Why? لِأَنَّ كُلَّهُمْ أَبٌ, because they are all fathers. وكذلك الآباء, وذلك أن المزوجة من الآباء وليست من الإخوة, والولاية غير المواريث, ولا ولاية لأحد من الأجداد دونه. الإمام الشافعي said, وكذلك, and like that, أن المزوجة من الآباء, and like that, those who are marrying, من الآباء, from the fathers, وليست من الإخوة, والولاية غير المواريث. الإمام الشافعي is giving a ta'leel, a reasoning, that the brothers وليست من الإخوة ولاية غير المواريث ولا ولاية لأحد مع الأجداد. نعم. Whilst the father is there and the father is present and he is there, the granddad doesn't have nothing to say. If the father then dies and he goes and he doesn't live in this world, then the granddad takes over. The granddad has power over the brothers. They don't have no wilaya except the inheritance. وَلَا وِلَايَةَ لِأَحَدٍ مَعَ الْأَجْدَادِ دُونَ أَبٍ أَقْرَبَ إِلَى الْمُزَوَّجَةِ مِنْهُ فَإِذَا لَمْ يَكُنْ آبَاءٌ. Now the granddad is gone. So the father is gone. The granddad is gone. Once the father and the granddad are gone, فَإِذَا لَمْ يَكُنْ آبَاءٌ فَلَا وِلَايَةَ لِأَحَدٍ مَعَ الْإِخْوَةِ. There's no one who has more precedence over the brothers. وَإِذَا اجْتَمَعَ الْإِخْوَةُ فَبَنُوا الْأَبِي وَالْأُمِّ أَوْلَى مِنْ بَنِي الْأَبِي. When the brothers now, within themselves, Al-Imam al-Shafi'i said, if they all come together, then the brother who has the same mom and same dad takes precedence over the one who has the same dad as her. وَإِذَا اجْتَمَعَ الْإِخْوَةُ, when the brothers come together, فَبَنُوا الْأَبِي وَالْأُمِّ, the one who has the same mom and same dad, أَوْلَى is more مِنْ بَنِي الْأَبِي than the one who has the same father as him, same father as her. فَإِذَا لَمْ يَكُنْ بَنُوا الْأَبِي, if there is not there's no brother who has the same mom and same dad. فَإِذَا لَمْ يَكُنْ, if there isn't, بَنُوا الْأَبِي أَوْلَى مِنْ غَيْرِهِمْ وَلَا وِلَايَةَ لِبَنِي أُمٍّ بِالْأُمِّ. So if the brother who has the same mom and same dad is gone, then the one who has same dad takes over. And if the one who has no, if the one who has the same dad is there, but there is the brother who has the same mother as her is there, Imam Shafi'i said, وَلَا وِلَايَةَ, he has no wilaya. لِبَنِي الْأُمِّ بُالْأُمِّ. The brother who has the same mom as her, not the same dad, he has the only same mom as her. And Imam Shafi'i said, he has no wilaya just because he has the same mom as her. He doesn't. وَلَا الْجَدْ, and also the granddad of the mother, the mother's granddad, the mother's dad, the mother's dad, which is the girl's granddad from her mom's side, he also doesn't have no wilaya. إِن لَمْ يَكُنْ عَصَبَة, if he's an asaba, then yes, he could be, what could he be to her? He could be the uncle, right? He could be her dad's uncle, which is a wilaya. He has asaba, he comes in the asaba. لِأَنَّ الْوِلَايَةَ لِلْعَصَبَة. And Imam Shafi'i said, because the wilaya is for the asaba, meaning the people have the same lineage as her, who she falls under the same line as names as her. The mother is not the same lineage. This is where asaba, or what asaba means. Imam Shafi'i's kalam is sarih, right? It's clear. Now we go to the kalam of the Hanabila. Abu al-Qasim Umar ibn al-Husayn al-Khiraqi, Mukhtasar al-Khiraqi, which is the sharah al-Imam ibn Qudamah, Wafuquddin ibn Qudamah, has placed on it. He has an explanation on it, which he called it al-Mughni, which is the sharah of Mukhtasar al-Khiraqi. Pay attention, this book, Mukhtasar al-Khiraqi, was written in the 4th Hijriyah. That's 1,000 years ago. This book has been written for 1,000 years. Naam. And Al-Imam Al-Khiraqi, he says, وَأَحَقُّ النَّاسِ بِنِكَاحِ الْمَرْأَةِ الْحُرَّةِ أَبُوهَا. The most rightful person, بِنِكَاحِ الْمَرْأَةِ, to marry the girl off, الْحُرَّةِ, the free woman, is أَبُوهَا, her father. ثُمَّ أَبُوهُ, and then his father, the father's father. وَإِنْ عَلَى, however high it goes. ثُمَّ إِبْنُهَا, and then her son. You see, this is where the Hanabila, they say that the son can come into place now, her son. Her own son they can marry her off. They can what? Marry her off. The scholars, they say, Shafi'i say that they shouldn't marry her off. The reason why they can't marry her off is because the child is normally going to be embarrassed to marry his mother off. He's going to be married. And also the Shafi'i say, because laysa min al-asabati, he's not from the asaba of the girl. He's not from her. He's not from her lineage, her lineage. He's not from her lineage, he's from the lineage of her husband. Ala kulli hal, ins and takes, the scholars differ upon. The Hanabila believe that. Thumma akhuha, her brother, li abiha wa ummiha, from the same mom and dad as her. Wal akhi lil abi mithluhu. And also the same is her brother, who has the same dad as her. Thumma awladuhum, and their children. Wa insafilu, even if they go as low as they want. Thumma al-umuma, and then the uncles. Thumma awladuhum, and their children. Wa insafilu, however low they go. Thumma umumati al-abi, and then the uncles of the father. If she doesn't have all of that, thumma al-mawla al-mun'im, if the girl was a slave, and the master who freed her is alive, he takes the praise, he takes wilaya of her as well. ثُمَّ أَقْرَبُ عَصَبَتِهِ ثُمَّ السُّلْطَانُ. And then we try to go to as closest to the asaba of the girl, however close we can to. If that is given up on, ثُمَّ السُّلْطَانُ, then the sultan takes over. فَالسُّلْطَانُ وَلِيُّ مَنْ لَا وَلِيَّ لَهُ. Because the sultan is a wali for the person who doesn't have no wilaya. So here we realize, subhanAllah, it's little who can get out of all of that, right? Very little anyone you can say to yourself who doesn't have any of those people. So there's no woman, generally speaking, who has no wilaya, generally speaking. Except there's two exceptions we're going to give later, inshallah ta'ala. Two exceptions. That, we have an explanation for that, inshallah. Now we've mentioned the Hanaf and the Malikiyya, and then we mentioned the Shafi'iyya, and we also mentioned the Hanabila. Let's look at the Zahiriyya, what do they believe? Al-Imam Ibn Hazm al-Zahiri, rahimahullah, in his Kitab al-Muhalla, he says, وَلَا يَحِلُّ لِلْمَرْأَةِ نِكَاحٌ وَلَا يَحِلُّ, it is not permissible, لِلْمَرْأَةِ, a woman, نِكَاحٌ, to marry, سَيِّبًا كَانَتْ أَوْ بِكْرًا, whether she is a thayyib, a divorcee or a widow, أَوْ بِكْرًا, or whether she's a virgin, I'm a virgin or non-virgin, it doesn't matter, إِلَّا بِإِذْنِ وَلِيِّهَا, except with the permission of her and the consent of her guardian. And then who is the wali? الْأَبِي, the father. أو الإخواتي, or her brothers. أو الجدي, or her granddad. أو الأعمامي, or her uncles. أو بني الأعمامي, or the children of her uncle. وإن بعد, however far they may be. والأقرب فالأقرب أولى. But the closer is more befitting. The closer they are. Each person, the closer they are to her, the closer they are as a asaba. Now I'm going to bring the last point of this particular heading, which is who is the wali? The ijma. So we brought the Hanaf. We brought the Malikiyya, Shafi'iyya, the Hanabila, we have that. And we brought the Zahiriyya. Now we're going to be ijma. قال الحافظ ابن عبد البر قال الحافظ ابن عبد البر في الاستذكار ابن عبد البر, he mentions in his كتاب الاستذكار, which is Al-Jami' al-Madahi bi-Fuqaha al-Amsar, is called Al-Istidkar Al-Jami' al-Madahi bi-Fuqaha al-Amsar. Ibn Abd al-Barr says, وَأَجْمَعَ الْعُلَمَاءَ عَلَىٰ أَنَّ الْوَلِيَّ الْمَذْكُورَ بِالْإِشَارَةِ إِلَيْهِ فِي هَذَا الْحَدِيثِ هُوَ الْوَلِيُّ مِنَ النَّسَبِ وَالْعَصَبَةِ وَاخْتَلَفُوا فِي غَيْرِ الْعَصَبَةِ. He says the ulama are unanimously in agreement. Ijma'a. أَنَّ الْوَلِيَّ الْمَذْكُورَ, that the wali that's been mentioned in the hadith, أَيُّ مَمْرَأَةٍ نَكَحَتْ بِغَيْرِ إِذْنِ وَلِيِّهَا, that wali that's spoken about in that hadith, which we mentioned when we were speaking about evidence. Ibn Abd al-Barr said, the wali that's mentioned here in this hadith, هُوَ الْوَلِيُّ مِنَ النَّسَبِ, it is the wali from her lineage, وَالْعَصَبَةِ, and her lineage. وَاخْتَلَفُوا, and they differed, فِي غَيْرِ الْعَصَبَةِ, the girl that's not her asaba. They differed upon it. اختلفوا. Ulul arham, is it in it or not? Fi ghayri al-asaba, anything that's not her asaba, are they in the wilaya or are they not? Such as the ulul arham, there is that difference. That's that khilaf. But the ijma' is that the asaba is the awliya. Should we add the ulul arham or should we not is the khilaf. Do you see where the ijma' is and you see where the khilaf is? Mm-hmm. Now that we've finished the heading of man huwa al-wali, who is the guardian? We've spoken about that. We're now going to go into إِذَا غَابَ وَلِيُّهَا, if the girl's wali is absent. What's the ruling? We know if he dies. This is all what happens if he dies, right? إِذَا مَاتَ الْوَلِيُّ, if the wali dies, we mentioned the father dies, the granddad takes over, and we gave the list. But what about if he's absent? He's alive. He's not dead. He's absent. What do we do in this situation? First of all, the ulama are of two opinions. Two opinions. اختلف العلماء, the scholars, they differed. If the wali is absent, he's absent. They differed upon it in two qawl, two opinions. The first qawl is what? Intiqal. What happens is intiqal. The wilaya is passed over to the closest person, just like if he died. If the father died, who would have taken over? The granddad, right? The father's father, right? They say in this situation, the same thing happens. It moves on to the next person. Automatically, if he's absent. Are you all with me? That opinion is held by Imam Abu Hanifa, rahimahullah, Imam Malik, and Imam Ahmed. That's the opinion of those three. Abu Hanifa, Imam Malik, and Imam al-Shafi'i. And a scholar by the name of Ibn Qas, rahimahullah. Ibn Qas, rahimahullah, he says, Ibn Qas says, pay attention, he's not from the three. He's not from the three. The three are only Abu Hanifa, Malik, and Ahmed. Like I said, Ibn Qas, rahimahullah, he mentions that Shafi'i, he attributes a statement to Imam al-Shafi'i, rahimahullah, that he also had this opinion. That he also had this opinion. If you want, you can find it in the Kitab al-Bayan, written by Yahya ibn Abi al-Khayr al-Imrani, rahimahullah. That kitab is al-Bayan, which is the sharh of al-Muhaddab li Ibn Ishaq al-Shirazi. He's explaining al-Muhaddab li Ibn Ishaq al-Shirazi. Udar Minhaj published it. But that's not the qawlul mu'tamad fi al-Madhhab al-Shafi'i. That's not the qawl which is mu'tamad, the view that's relied upon. The qawlul mu'tamad in the Shafi'iyya is a second opinion, which is that the absence of the father, it moves on to the sultan. فالسلطان ولي من لا ولي له, they say. That it moves on to the sultan. It's not intiqal. Intiqal doesn't happen here, they said. They said it moves on to the wali. The wali takes over. That's the qawl al-mu'tamad fi al-madhhab al-shafi'iyya. But here we have to understand something. And this is where the mistake happens from some people. The absent, according to the scholars, is categorized into two. The ghaybuba is two types. The first type is, and I'm going to, inshallah ta'ala, bring the quote of Ibn Qudam and others, is ghaybah munqati'ah. Ghaybah, which is munqati'ah, a disconnected absence. And the second one is غَيْبَةٌ غَيْرَ مُنْقَطِعَةٌ, a غَيْبَةٌ absent, which is not disconnected. So what's the difference between the two? And what do they each mean? Is what we're going to go through with the quotes of the ulama. So when we explain the first one, or the second one, which is the غَيْبَةٌ غَيْرَ مُنْقَطِعَةٌ, once we explain that one, then you'll automatically know what is مُنْقَطِعَةٌ. موفق الدين ابن قدامة in his كتاب المغني, which is a sharh of مختصر الخرقي, he says, إذا غاب الرجل عن امرأته, if a man is absent from his woman, لم يخلو من حالين, he can't get out of two situations, one of two situations. The first one is أحدهما أن تكون غيبة غير منقطعة. The first one is that it is what? غيبه غير منقطعه. It is a غيبه absent which is احدهما ان تكون غيبه غير منقطعه اي غيبه absent which is not disconnected. يعرف this one how is it disconnected, why how what does it mean غير منقطع. He says يعرف خبره, his information is known, his news is known, his whereabouts. ويأتي كتابه, his writings reach you, he sends letters to you and فهذا ليس لامرأتي أن تتزوج في قول أهل. So he's talking about the issue of what? A husband. He's talking about this here. A woman who her husband leaves her. Because this same issue applies on it. A wife, her husband leaves her. You see? And he's absent from her. The غيبوبة here is also two. If the غياب, the absent, the غيبة here right now is منقطع أو غير منقطع. If he's sending her letters and he's speaking and he's sending her letters and emails or whatever, she can't say my husband's away so I can go and get married. No. The same is the wilaya. The same. Because he's going to bring quotes later. I just wanted from this part to explain what the ghaybah ghayra munqati'ah means. Sahih? Al-Allama ibn Hajar al-Haytami. Al-Allama ibn Hajar al-Haytami in his Fatawa al-Fiqhiyyah al-Kubra. Pay attention. He says, ونقول إن سهلت مراجعة أحدهما أعني الولي أو الحاكم إذا غاب إلى مرحلتين فأكثر تعينت ولم يجوز لها أن تولي عدلا يزوجها. He says, Ibn Hajar al-Haytami in his Fatawa al-Fiqhiyyah al-Kubra. He's a Shafi'i. موفق الدين من قدام وزي حنبلي. He says, ونقول we will say, إن سهلت مراجعة أحدهما, if it is easy to converse and to go back with two, أعني الولي, one of the two, meaning the guardian or the hakim, the Muslim leader. It's easy for her to converse with him or get to him, or she's able to get to the wali. إذا غابا, they're both absent. They are both absent. If she can still get to him, and he responds back to her, إلى مرحلتين فأكثر تعينت, it is not. Sorry, it is obligatory on her to converse with her wali and also to converse with her hakim. ولم يجوز, and it is not permissible for her أن تولي عدلا يزوجها, for her to pass over her wilaya to a reliable man to marry her off by claiming that the husband is away. By claiming that the will is away. لأنه إنما جاز لها ذلك للضرورة. Because the reason why this was permitted for her, which is if the غيبة, the absent is منقطعة, disconnected. The reason why it was permitted for her to get married is because what? The reason why it was made للضرورة, necessity. وعند مراجعة الولي, but if the person is able to converse with the willy and speak back and he sends and you send, or the hakim, لم يوجد الولي للضرورة. أو الحاكم, إن لم يوجد الولي لا ضرورة. At this particular point, there's no ضرورة anymore now. Because you actually got control to converse with the wali or the hakim. So what did we know from this? It's somebody, do you know their whereabouts? And if you send them something, they can respond to you. Now we're going to look more into what does that mean? موفق الدين ابن قدامة in his Mughni, he says, والفصل الثاني في الغيبة المنقطعة التي يجوز للأبعد التزويج في مثلها ففي قول الخراقي. He says, the غيبة which is منقطعة, that is permissible للأبعد التزويج في مثلها, that the woman can go and get married. There's a غيبة منقطعة, it's disconnected. That it is permissible for the woman to get married in is, ففي قول الخراقي, in the statement of خراقي. In the statement of خراقي is, هي من لا يصل إليها الكتاب. أي you send her a letter, you send him a letter, the wali, it doesn't get to him. أو يصل, or it reaches him, فلا يجيبه, he doesn't respond. عنه. لأن مثل هذا تتعذر مراجعته. This one, it is hard for her to get back to him all the time like this. She can't just keep sending him letters. بالكلية, in totality, she can't. فَتَكُونُ مُنْقَطِعَةً, this is disconnected. أَيَنْقَطِعُ عَنْ إِمْكَانِ تَزْوِيجِهَا. In other words, it is, he's disconnected from being able to marry her off. You see, وَقَالَ الْقَاضِي, قَاضِي أَبِي يَعْلَى, that's who it is. When you hear Hanabila say, they mean قَاضِي أَبِي يَعْلَى. يَجِبُ أَنْ يَكُونَ حَدُّ الْمَسَافَةِ. And he goes, وَقَالَ الْقَاضِي, قَاضِي أَبِي يَعْلَى said, يَجِبُ, it is obligatory, أَنْ يَكُونَ حَدُّ الْمَسَافَةِ. Now we want to know the distance. The distance is that she can say is munqati'a is alla taraddada alqawafil fi sana. In 1 year, she sends a letter. The qafila, the caravan that goes, should not be able to go, so it can't go, come back and go and come back. So it goes from her, it goes, comes back, and it goes in the year. If it's able to go and come back, and go and come back. Keep it in mind, qafila will take 3 months, 4 months per journey. If he can do that, na'am. لِأَنَّ الْكُفْءَ يَنْتَظِرُ سَنَى. So 1 year he can wait. So in other words, this can only take place in a year. If you times 3, times 4, how much is it? Yeah? So she can wait for that. So the man who wants to marry her can wait for that long. Mm-hmm. He can wait for that long. 1 year. He waits for 1 year. وَلَا يَنْتَذُرْ أَكْثَرَ مِنْهَا. He can't wait for longer than that. فَيَلْحَقُ الضَّرَرُ بِتَرْكِ تَزْوِيجِهَا. Then this woman will never get married. She will never get married. The harm of not being married is going to come to her. Ahmed said, until Imam Wafiq Qadim al-Qudami said, Ahmed qala, Imam Ahmed said, إِذَا لَمْ يَكُنْ وَلِيٌّ حَاضِرٌ. If there's no wali that's there, مِنْ عَصَبَتِهَا. Imam Ahmed said this. And Imam Ahmed said, إِذَا لَمْ يَكُنْ وَلِيٌّ حَاضِرٌ. If there's no wali that's present, مِنْ عَصَبَتِهَا, from her asaba, كَتَبَ إِلَيْهِمْ, she writes to them, حَتَّى يَأْذَنُوا, until they permit it for her. إِلَّا أَن تَكُونَ غَيْبَةً مُنْقَطِعَةً, unless it's a غَيْبَة, disconnected. She's disconnected from that world. لَا تُدْرَكُ إِلَّا بِالْكُلْفَةِ وَمَشَقَّةً. And she will not be able to get to it unless it will take كُلْفَ and مَشَقَّةً. It's very beyond comprehension, the efforts that she has to go through. Meaning it's going to be more a year and a half, or maybe even 2 years. What did she do? فَسُلْطَانُ وَلِيُّ مَنْ لَا وَلِيَّ لَهُ. So the sultan is the guardian for the one who doesn't have a guardian. And then Ibn Qudama says, وَهَذَا الْقَوْلُ إِنْ شَاءَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى أَقْرَبُهَا إِلَى الصَّوَابِ. This statement is the closest to the strongest opinion, inshaAllah, with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's permission and will. قال ابن حزم في المحلة. ابن حزم says رحمه الله. وروينا عن الحجاج بن منهال أخبرنا أبو هلال قال سألت الحسن فقلت. ابن حزم رحمه الله says in his محلة. He says عن الحجاج بن منهال, from حجاج بن منهال, who said أخبرنا أبو هلال. أبو هلال told us. قال سألت الحسن فقلت. I asked Imam Hassan al-Basri, who is a student of the companions, تابعي جليل. I asked him, I said to him, Abu Sa'id, عن امراة, a woman, خطبها رجل, a man wants to get married to her. ووليها غائب, and her wali is absent. بسجستان, he's in Sijistan, he's absent, but he's in Sijistan. ولوليها ها هنا ولي, and her wali, there's another wali here for here. And then there's the next one. He's in the next one in command is here. أَيُزَوِّجُهَا وَلِيُّ. Can he marry her of this wali? لِوَلِيَّهَا, for the other wali. Can he just take his place? قَالَ لَا. Hassan al-Basri said, no. وَلَكِنْ يُكْتُبُ إِلَيْهِ. Write to the father. Or write to the first one. قُلْتُ لَهُ. I said to him. Who's saying this? Abu Hilal said, إِنَّ الْخَاطِبَ لَا يَصْبِرُ. The one who wants to get married cannot be patient for this long. Imam Hassan al-Basri said, فَلْيَصْبِرْ. Let him be patient. Let him be patient. If you want to get married in this, you want to do a halal way, then be patient. قَالَ لَهُ رَجُلٌ. Then a man said to Hassan al-Basri in the gathering, إِلَى مَتَى يَصْبِرُ. For how long will he be patient for? And then Hassan al-Basri said, يَصْبِرُ كَمَا صَبَرْ أَهْلُ الْكَهْ. He's going to be patient like the patient of people of Kahf. And that's 309 years. وَهَذَا مُبَالَغَةُ فِي الْكَلَامِ. That's Ziyada, Hasan al-Basri just meant, and he wanted to emphasize on, get hold of him. He didn't want the people to take it very lightly. When he said, يَصْبِرُ كَمَا صَبَرَ أَهْلُ الْكَهْفِ, that she has to get in contact with her wali, her first wali. This opinion is the qawl of Jabir ibn Zaydin, he said, Ibn Hazm. وَمَكْحُولُ وَوَا قَوْلُ ibn Shubruma. Shubruma believed this. وَابْنُ أَبِي لَيْلَى وَسُفْيَانَ الثَّوْرِيُّ وَالْحَسَنُ ibn Yahya وَالشَّافِعِيُّ وَأَحْمَدُ وَإِسْحَاقُ وَأَبُو عُبَيْدَ وَعَبْدُ اللَّهِ ibn Mubarak. That's the opinion of those a'immah, those great noble imams. Ibn Qudama said in his Kitab al-Mughni, وَظَاهِرُ كَلَامِ أَحْمَدُ, and from the apparent of the statement of Imam Ahmad is, أَنَّهُ إِذَا كَانَتِ الْغَيْبَةُ غَيْرَ مُنْقَطِعَةٍ أَنَّهُ يُنْتَظَرُ وَيُرَاصِلُ حَتَّى يَقْدَمَ أَوْ يُوَكِّلَ. Ibn Qudama says, from the apparent of the statement of Imam Ahmad is, أَنَّهُ إِذَا كَانَتِ الْغَيْبَةُ غَيْرَ مُنْقَطِعَةٍ, that if the absence is the one that's not disconnected, meaning he can be reached, أَنَّهُ يُنْتَظَرُ, he is waited for. وَيُرَاسَلُ, letters are sent to him. حَتَّى يَقْدَمَ, until he comes forward. أَوْ يُوَكِّلَ, or he passes it over to somebody. He says, I can't come and I'm not able to do this. I pass the wilaya over to Fulan ibn Fulan. Now we finished. If the wali is absent, there's another issue that I need to mention. And that is, so there's two other issues that I need to mention in this part, bi-idhnillahi al-kareem. First of all, man huwa sultan? Who is the sultan? And the reason why we mention these issues, each one has to be explained, is that there are people who are going to try to find a loophole in trying to define their own understanding of each point. So who is a wali? We explained that. We know what a wali is now. Then who is a sultan now? Because the person will say to you, oh, this brother I gave it to, he's my sultan. فَسُلْطَانُ وَلِيُّ مَنْ لَا وَلِيَّ لَهُ. He's my wali. He's my sultan now. I gave it to him, so he married me off. Ibn Qudama rahimahullah, he says, in his Kitab al-Mughni, which is a sharah of Mukhtasar al-Khiraqi, he says, ثُمَّ السُلْطَانُ, he says, مَسَأَلَةٌ, he chapped it somewhere in his Kitab al-Mughni, and he says, ثُمَّ السُلْطَانُ, and the sultan, لَا نَعْلَمُ خِلَافًا بَيْنَ أَهْلِ الْعِلْمِ في أن للسلطان ولاية تزويج المرأة عند عدم أوليائها أو عضلهم. He says, we do not know a difference of opinion amongst the scholars that the sultan, he has the wilaya of marrying the woman off when the awliya are absent or they don't exist. أو عضلهم, or if they're stopping her from getting married. Fuss. And then after that he goes on to saying, وَالسُّلْطَانُ هَا هُنَا, the sultan that I mean here is, هُوَ الْإِمَامُ, it is the imam. أَوِ الْحَاكِمُ, or is the hakim of the Muslims. أَوْ مَنْ تَفَوَّضَا إِلَيْهِ ذَلِكَ, or whoever they delegate the responsibility to. It's the Muslim leader. Or the qadi, the judge. The hakim, the judge. أَوْ مَنْ فَوَّضَا إِلَيْهِ, or whoever they delegate the job to. Or whoever they delegate the job to, they give it to. Here now, we've learned what the sultan is. The sultan is the imam or the hakim of the Muslims. Or whoever they pass it over to. They give it to a qadi and they say to the qadi, you go do it. The qadi takes over it. Good. Now this is another issue, which is a woman who says, I do not have a wali and there's no sultan for me. Sahih? And this can happen from two places only, generally speaking. There are exceptions, but generally speaking, these are the only two avenues or the two ways that it can occur. The first one is a woman who is born from a wedlock. Zina. Her father is not, this man who gave, is not a wali for her. That's the first one. If a woman and a man commit zina, the child they give birth to is not the lineage of this man. He's not a wali for her. He's not a wali for this woman. That's one. The second one is a woman who came from Islam, came from Kufr, sorry, and came into Islam. She's a revert. And her family are all Kufar. There's no Muslim family member. She's the only Muslim one in her family. If her father is a Muslim, then he's a wali. But she, her father is a kafir. What is the situation here? Here, the ulama have done what is known as ijtihad. They've done ijtihad. So this is applying to a woman who has no wali. And there is no sultan. How can it apply where there's no sultan? There's no sultan in the sense we live in this country. There's no sultan. There's no hakim and there's no imam Muslim here. Sahih? So what does this woman do? And what's her situation like? فَإِنْ لَمْ يُوجَدْ لِلْمَرْأَةِ وَلِيٌّ وَلَا سُلْطَانٌ There's no wali and there is no sultan. Then the ulama, they done ijtihad and they use the qa'ida, which is إِذَا ضَاقَ الْأَمْرُ اتَّسَعَ إِذَا ضَاقَ الْأَمْرُ اتَّسَعَ If a matter becomes hard and tough, the sharia makes it open. It makes it, اتَّسَعَ, it opens it. And it makes it lean and soft. قال ابن حزم في المحلى ابن حزم said in his kitab المحلى He says وصح It is authentically transmitted from عن ابن سيرين محمد ابن سيرين تابعي جليل نوب تابعي في امرأة A woman لا ولي لها She has no ولي Pay attention here Because later when we speak about the issue of the shubuhat and what some people will take these references in these quotes unjustly We all know the Arabic language. لا ولي لها. لا ولي لها. This لا is نافية. نافية الجنس تعمل عمل إن. This لا here is نافية الجنس تعمل عمل إن. That it works in the place of the إن. The ism of it is which is ولي. It's an ism which is مفرد. مبني على الفتح لا محل له من الإعراب. مبني على الفتح. And we already took that what? That when we're studying the kitab Daf'u Ihami Lil-Dirab by Muhammad Amin al-Shanqiti, that the la nafiyatu ta'amalu amala inna, we took what was it? Nassun fil umum. It's a nass fil umum, meaning there's nothing to get out of it. So, in other words, la waliya laha, she has no wali whatsoever. There's nobody at all. She has no wilaya, anyone to give her wilaya to. La sultan. ولا عصبة ولا أولو الأرحام even if you take that opinion she has no one she's only by herself and that happens through what as I said she's born through zina or she's what she just came into Islam she's a revert فولت رجلا أمرها if that woman passes her affairs to a man and we're going to look at that man has to be a man of integrity عدل a just person a noble person فزوجها and he marries her off. قال ابن سيرين ابن سيرين then said لا بأس there is no problem بذلك in that situation. in that situation there's no problem. المؤمنون بعضهم أولياء بعض. That verily the believers are allies to one another. So she finds a righteous practicing brother and she puts her wilaya in his hand. And she says to him marry me off. I have no one else to marry me off. We use the qa'ida إِذَا ضَاقَ الْأَمْرُ اتَّسَعَ If every man says, no, I'm not going to do it for you, this woman will never get married. Her matters are very serious. So we say to her, الْمُؤْمِنُونَ بَعْضُهُمْ أَوْلِيَاءُ بَعْضٍ That the believers are allies to one another. So he takes her over her wilaya. Abu Zakariya Yahya ibn Sharaf al-Nawawi in his kitab رَوْضَةُ الطَّالِبِينَ وَعُمْدَةُ He brings a statement which the scholars are in disagreement on, and inshallah ta'ala, when we speak about later, bi'idhnillah, we're going to bring this up. Which is, in our next part, we're going to bring this up, inshallah. Yunus ibn Abdul A'la, he says, Rawa Yunus ibn Abdul A'la, anna al-Shafi'iyya radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, ama rahimahullahu ta'ala anhu, qal, idha kana fi rufaqati imra'atun la waliya laha, fawallat amraha rajulan, hatta yuzawwijaha jaza. Al-imamu, Yunus ibn Abdul A'la brings that Imam al-Shafi'i who says, if there is a woman who has no wali, la waliya laha, we have the again, the la, which is nafiyatun, نافية الجنس تعمل عمل إن صحيح فولت أمرها and she then passes her ولاية over to somebody حتى يزوجها so he can marry her off جازة شاف عيسى this is permissible because this woman does not have anybody to marry her off so according to Imam الشافعي رحمه الله based on his statement it is permissible for her to be married off or it is permissible for her to marry وقال ابن قدامة في المغني ابن قدامة he said in his مغني which is the شرح المختصر الخراقي he says فإن لم يوجد للمرأة ولي ولا سلطان ابن قدامة says if there's no ولي or there's no سلطان for this woman فعن أحمد it is transmitted from Imam Ahmad ما يدل that which shows على أنه يزوجها رجل عدل بإذنها that a noble, righteous man will marry her off. Imam Ahmad rahimahullah from his statement is that which shows that if she has no wali and there is no sultan, then Imam Ahmad said, يزوجها رجل عدل بإذنها. A man who is adl, who is just, integrity or noble, he marries her off with her permission. بِإِذْنِهَا she has to be permitted. He can't just go and get marry her off to whoever he wants. He can't. And she is the one who gives him the wilaya. She gives it to him. And this man has to be a noble man. She can't just give it to every single man. She can't just give it to every single individual. Inshallah ta'ala, we'll stop there today for this part. بِإِذْنِ الْكَرِيمِ We have to speak more about the other parts to come, which is, what about the child that is born from this nikah without the wali's permission? What ruling does it take and what not? And other things, inshallah ta'ala, that we will be speaking about. Anything which I have said that was wrong, فَإِنَّهُ مِنِّي وَمِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ وَاللَّهُ وَرَسُولُ بَرِئَانِ مِنْ It is from me, الشَّيْطَانِ, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. سُبْحَانَكَ اللَّهُمَّ بِحَمْدِكَ أَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ أَسْتَغْفِرُكَ وَأَتُوبُ إِلَيْكَ